How many of you believe that students should be allowed to carry their cell phones to school? Chances are you have a yes or no answer, and most people are clearly divided on that, and they have strong valid points for both. We're going to add to that evergreen debate today, and joining me are Sasha Mishra and Shubhangi Shresht. Sasha is going to argue that cell phones should be banned in schools, and Shubhangi is going to counter that as she believes that they should not. They should be allowed. They should be allowed. Sasha, you have 1 minute on the clock. Why do you believe that they should be banned?
Cell phones should be banned in the schools because the first reason being is that they are a major distraction. Instead of focusing on what the teacher is speaking in the class, you know, the attention of the student will be diverted by his or her cell phone. And instead of talking, you know, instead of sharing their tiffins, you know, people will be taking selfies and taking pictures of the food they are having and posting it on, you know, various social networking sites. And the personal interaction between the students will just decrease. Instead of actually playing on the playground, they'll be playing games on the cell phones. Mm-hmm. So thus, you know, it will serve as a major distraction. The other reason being is that the cell phones can be misused. You know, the students in the school, you know, would use it as a status symbol, you know, to act cool that they have cell phones.
I have a fancy phone.
Yes, I have a fancy phone, and not all the students come from the same economic background. So I think this would lead to further issues such as bullying. Mm-hmm. And also cell phones can be misused in the way that they can be used for cheating.
Shubhangi, why do you believe otherwise?
I believe that cell phones should not be banned in schools, primarily for three reasons. The first being that cell phones in itself are a very useful commodity, say for taking notes or when you miss out on classes, you need to record stuff. You can share it with your other classmates who were there in other activities, maybe playing football for the school or whatever. Mm-hmm. Secondly, in case of very particular situations, like when you have an emergency or say you're getting back home and you have to travel far, your school is really far from your home, you need to be in contact with someone, maybe your parents or anyone for that matter. Mm-hmm. So then cell phones are really useful at that time. That's something you can't replace with anything else. Mm-hmm. Thirdly, when a person is 15 or 16, you talk about him growing up and actually finally taking up responsibilities. And then you go ahead and say, no, you can't even take a cell phone. Where is the freedom? You're not even allowing him to make his own decisions.
Okay. Do you believe that cell phones can be distracting in school?
I believe that cell phones can be distracting only when you give it a very free use. Here I'm not talking about cell phones being there throughout. I'm talking about a regulation. For example, cheating, as she said about cheating. So during the exams, take away their cell phones. During particular tests or particular classes, when you actually have something going on, take away their cell phones. Have a regulated use, not a complete ban, but yeah, a regulated use should be there.
I don't think regulation would help as such because, see, the main idea of, you know, one of the main fundamental purposes of a school is also in some way to inculcate discipline in a child. Mm-hmm. You know, throughout, why do we have uniforms? Why do we have, you know, breaks? And, you know, why do we have all these fixed schedules? It's because to inculcate some amount of discipline in a child. So when you introduce cell phones, I mean, we are children at that time, you know, we do not have such self-constraint and, you know, self-discipline that, you know, we won't misuse it as such. And apart from this, if we cannot, since again this reason comes into it, it will be a major distraction. You cannot regulate each and every child, you know, a student can always sneak in a cell phone. And the whole idea of a school is, I mean, what about the personal interactions? You know, even after school, you will be using a cell phone, you will be. So during the school time, why do you want to text your friend when he's sitting right next to you? Why do you want to play a game on your phone when you can actually go and play on the ground? And when a teacher is there, I mean, teachers find it already hard, to handle a class, you know, to handle a bunch of students. And, you know, introducing a cell phone would further harden, you know, would further, you know, deteriorate her position in the class. So I think a regulation won't really as such help and the problem, you know.
When you're talking about discipline, that, you know, in schools, students need to maintain certain discipline.
Discipline, yes.
What if cell phones were introduced, but the regulation was part of the discipline, that you can bring your cell phones, but you need to maintain discipline and keep them in for when you're in class or when you're on taking a test or something like that?
Okay, so the first reason, if we allow cell phones, then I think, you know, then we can always tell them, you know, wear civil clothes. You know, why do we have uniforms? We can wear whatever we want. Then, you know, you can have, you know, restrictions on that too. Mm-hmm. I think during the school time is a period where a certain amount, yes, this is a point where, you know, you can always have regulation and, you know, you can inculcate a certain amount of discipline that. But then the whole
idea... See, there's no stopping it. Yes. You can say, why don't you allow this?
Exactly. There's no stopping it. You know, I mean, why during this school time? I mean, when you can listen to your teachers, when your students are there, even after the schools, you can use your cell phones. And then there's always college. So I think school period is a time where I think we should not be allowed cell phones, because it'll prove to be a major distraction. It can be misused in various ways.
Shivangi, she's speaking about discipline and how that's not going to work with the regulation that you were talking about. My question is, when the child is in school, the school is responsible for that child. So if the student needs to go somewhere after school or has, I don't know, cricket practice or something that they need to inform their parents, do they really need to have a cell phone, or can they go through the school and just communicate that to their parents? Is a cell phone necessary? Isn't the school supposed to act as between the parent and the student?
Till how long will you go with that? Like, there's one school phone, and then if a person has to, say, leave the school at like 5, he has a late cricket practice or he's in some extracurricular activity, he has to travel all the way home, take a route which is not that safe. At that point, you can't go back to the cell phone, to the office phone or the school phone. You see, as Indians, we have this habit of picking on always the darker side of things, be it a cell phone, be it a laptop, be it the internet. And then we always forget that it has many uses as well. The solution is not to ramble about it or whine about it or go ahead and say, just put a ban on it. It's about regulation. It's about using it the right way. So yeah, that's what I would like to say.
She raised an important point that maybe as Indians, we do look at the dark side.
We do look at the darker side of things. But here we're talking about introducing cell phones, allowing cell phones in school. School period is a time where, I mean, then it would, what would be the difference between a school and a college? I mean, if you're given so much freedom as such, the main purpose of the school would be defeated. You know, one of the purposes is to, you know, bring children together, to inculcate some amount of, you know,
communication, interaction,
and, you know, to, as again, I'm going to reiterate my fact, that inculcate some amount of discipline, you know, self-discipline. As such, if we introduce cell phones in the other, they'll be like, why can't we wear civil clothes? Why can't we do this? I mean, we can impose restrictions on that too. But then if we introduce cell phones, I mean, we're already using, I know everyone has a cell phone, even a beggar right now has a cell phone. But then we are already using cell phones even after school.
So just don't do it during school
time. Why do you need to do it during the school times, when you have your teachers to listen to, when you have your fellow colleagues to talk to? Why do you need it during that particular time? I don't think it is required.
Are there any benefits of bringing your phone to school? Like, she was talking earlier about notes and things like that.
Yeah. Okay. So now talking about these notes and security. Okay, now if a student is absent, you know, like, then, you know, people would not take this classes very seriously. It would be like, you know, some person record kar lega, you know, this XYZ person, notes to mili jayenge. Why do you need to attend school? Again, the purpose is defeated. And when we're talking about security issues, the parent can always contact the place where his or her child is going to. You know, if he's going for tuitions, you should have the tuition teacher's number, the tuition center's number, and also the school is also responsible, so they can make contact in both ways. God forbid if a child is kidnapped, it's not that the cell phone is really going to help the child, you know, contact his parents. You know, the cell phone is thrown away. I know that's a point which is...
You mean if something bad happens,
has to happen, it will happen.
A cell phone's not going to play a very important role,
yes. And in the sense, we should even see how it's going to be misused in major ways, and the purpose is defeated. I mean, you know, then we can also... There won't be a difference between a school and a college and a working place, you know.
So, Shivangi, Sasha's still seeing it on the dark side of cell phone usage, and you've been talking about the benefits. What do you think is responsible cell phone usage in schools? If you feel that cell phones should be allowed, how can the school ensure that they're used correctly?
Take, for example, exams. Like, she talked about cheating, which is, I agree that it's very easy if you have a cell phone to cheat. So during exams, you all have to submit your cell phone, say, right before you enter the classroom. During classes, you can say the internet, the Wi-Fi, it has blocked some of the sites so that there's no wrong usage as stuff. Because we see cell phones as just tools for you watching the wrong stuff and stuff. So yeah, block those sites maybe, regulate it during the exams. During the classes, make sure that the person is not always on a cell phone. If he's using it for recording, use it and just keep it on his side like that. And if you see 2-3 people actually giggling or laughing because of that, take it away at that point of time, because you're not using it responsibly.
Okay, so for example, you know, as you mentioned, the fact that, you know, if you're taking you know, class, we are, you know, recording the lecture and, you know, we are sending class notes to that. I mean, wouldn't it be a hindrance to the teacher itself? I mean, the teacher is talking. I mean, the basic purpose is again defeated, because why people would start, students would start taking school very casually. It's the main difference when you come to college and when you go to school. I mean, you do take school, you know, school is there, you need to go. And again, you know, the, it'll be like people will be more distracted by the fact that, you know, a cell phone is there, and you'll be like, let's do something else. And the teacher's job would be harder, you know, even before not having a cell phone. I mean, if, you know, we are recording a lecture and at that point, you know, another student, naughty kids, just, you know, starts, you know, messing around with the phone, and then, you know, again, the whole, you know, the class would be disrupted, the teacher would be, you know, would be distracted, and, you know, people would start, students would take it casually, and then, you know, as such, other restrictions would be, you know, would be elevate, you know, would, you know, would decrease. They would be like, why do we need to wear uniforms? Why do we need to have breaks?
What about, so, you know, when we're talking about doing bad things on the phone or incorrect or questionable things, right. You also have computers in schools, and those are regulated in terms of websites are blocked, Facebook, certain, social media might be blocked, and you use it only for a certain set of things. Do you think that's possible with cell phones?
That, I think it would not be possible till a certain extent, because see, when we're talking about computers, they're used for the computer classes, you know, for whatever curriculum we have. And that time, you know, the computers are in the fixed room and it's not ours. I mean, the property is of the, you know, of the school. This is belonging to us.
It's private property. It's a private property. You can have it in your pocket.
Exactly. So what happens if a student, if a teacher, or if another student, you know, messes with the another student's, you know, cell phone, what would happen at that point? Who would take responsibility? The school? What if someone finds something on each other's phone? And, you know, it can be, it is, and as I mentioned earlier, it will be used as a status symbol to act cool. You know, people, it would lead to bullying that, you know, okay, I have this phone, you don't even have a phone. How can you not have one? So, and if you're talking about class notes, what about the student who does not have a cell phone?
Okay. Shwangi, what is your response to that? You know, all classes have that one naughty boy who, you know, will take a cell phone, do something.
No, I'd like to say here that you're forgetting about the fact that in recent times, the extracurricular activities have exponentially increased, and the demand of the schools, of the students to participate in that has also increased. What about those people? They are not taking it casually. They just have to manage it well. Here, for them, a cell phone, a recording on the cell phone will be like a boon. They'll be able to manage it very well because the school hours are fixed. So are the practice hours or whatever. So they just practice whenever they have to. They go home, they have time, and they use the recordings for studying or whatever. For them, for those people who are actually not taking it casually but are actually working for the school, this will be a great help. What about them?
What if you're allowed, for people who have like after school practice, what if you're allowed to bring your cell phone to school? This happened in my school. You could bring your cell phone to school, deposit it with your teacher, and then when you're leaving, you get to pick it up when you're staying for practice. Do you think that would be a solution?
That's
a regulate. Or do you believe that they can be allowed, like in break time or lunch time, to have their cell phones as well?
No, I think break time and lunch time are for interaction. But then again, it should be left to the child itself. It's a personal choice. Like if you want to interact there, like with your peers.
So this is perhaps after a certain class, because class 10, you're allowed to bring your cell phone or something like that?
Yeah, because you're 15, you're 16, there has to be a sense of freedom. Okay. You have to be given the ability to actually make choices. You can't be spoon-fed everything for the rest of your life. Once you go to college, you're like, okay, now you can do whatever you want. You have to now gradually build that up, right? Yeah. And this is one of the ways in which you can actually build it up.
As you mentioned, you know, we can, you know, deposit to the phone. And in that, a certain stipulation can come whether a child's parents can, you know, go and speak to the, you know, the teachers and principal, and, you know, can explain his or her case. Mm-hmm. And when you talk about after, you know, extracurricular activities, I know it has increased. It has exponentially increased. I mean, you know, everyone wants to do everything. But they take place after a certain time. I mean, when our parents were young, there were no cell phones that time.
So how did they manage?
I mean,
I wonder that, actually. Even, I don't know how people manage.
Exactly. How were they managing? Mm-hmm. I mean, see, then school is an institution where, you know, basic values are incorporated into a child. You know, you learn, you build a foundation is built out there. And when you're talking about given, you know, you have been given freedom of choice, you should be given choices when you're 15 or 16. I mean, then you are actually entering into the phase of college. Like right now, we are college students.
Yeah.
I mean, then there's no difference left. I mean, you know, yes, I mean, if there are certain situations where, you know, a child really requires, then obviously the parents can go and speak to them.
So but certain cases.
Certain cases, and as such, when we're talking about extracurricular activities, it's not just one person. Mm. There's so many students who are doing it also.
Yeah.
And even in our previous times, people were still doing it. I mean, now suddenly you require a cell phone to do it. So, I mean, I don't
Shivangi,
see the point
closing
of it.
Comments.
I just like to say that it would be very naive of all of us right now here to actually compare the old times and what is going on right here. If you have a facility, use it. It's there to make it better. Use it to make your lives better. Use it for the freedom, but use it correctly. Instead of imparting the banning thing, impart the education of how to use it, how to use it in a regulated manner. That's what I feel and that's what I believe strongly.
Okay, you made your point very eloquently, both of you. Thank you, ladies, for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
The debate over whether cell phones can be allowed in schools is not going to end anytime soon, especially when they're now increasing pros on the different things that you can do on your cell phone and how that can help you in the class. This debate's not going to end anytime soon, and we'll be back on it. We're going to slip into a short break, and we have lots more on the other side.